Boulder City, Nevada. Hoover Dam towers more than 700 feet above Black Canyon on the Arizona-Nevada state line, holding back the waters of the Colorado River. On top of the dam, where visitors peer down the graceful white arc of its face, one of its Art Deco-style towers is adorned with a work of art that memorializes the purposes of the dam. In five relief sculptures by Oscar Hansen, muscular men are shown gripping a boat's wheel, harvesting an armful of wheat, standing beside cascading water and lifting a heavy weight overhead. With the concrete figures are words that encapsulate why the dam was built, as laid out in a 1928 law: flood control, navigation, irrigation, water storage and power. The effects of years of severe drought and temperatures pushed higher by climate change are strikingly visible along Lake Mead's retreating shorelines near Las Vegas, where the growing bathtub ring of whitish minerals coats the rocky desert slopes. Since 2000, the water level in Lake Mead, which is the reservoir formed by Hoover Dam and holds the title of the largest reservoir in the country, has dropped about 140 feet. It is now just 37% full, headed for a first-ever official shortage and sinking toward its lowest levels since it was filled. One of the West's driest 22-year periods in centuries is colliding with the river's chronic overuse. As the reservoir falls toward record lows, its decline threatens the water supplies of cities and farmlands, and reveals how the system of managing water in the desert Southwest faces growing risks. Tech. Twitter will promote credible information with new climate change topic after criticism over misinformation. Mike Bernardo of the Federal Bureau of Reclamation leads a team of engineers and hydrologists who plan water releases from Hoover Dam, as well as Davis and Parker Dams downstream, sending flows that travel through pipelines and canals to Phoenix, Los Angeles and farmlands in the US and Mexico that produce crops such as hay, cotton, grapes and lettuce. Bernardo's team also sets power generation goals and produces a monthly report with the latest projections of how reservoir levels will likely change over the next 24 months. Lately, each month's report has brought worsening numbers. Predicted water level declines have grown as estimates of inflows into Lake Powell, the upstream reservoir, have shrunk due to extremely parched conditions across the upper watershed in the Rocky Mountains, where much of the river's flow originates as melting snow. Unfortunately, due to how dry things have been, Bernardo says, what we're seeing is Lake Powell's elevations are dropping. And that will mean less water flowing into Lake Mead for the rest of the year. The past 12 months have been among the driest on record across the Colorado River Basin.